these tactics before, but the funding, I was frustrated. I was frustrated by hammer angle injury. I thought I was going to lose to two of guys. Of course, I knew maybe only two guys could beat me. Maybe even Jake and Pakal was going to beat me. But today in the morning, I changed my plan. I say I'm an Olympic champion, and I know I'm the best in the event. I say no. I'm going to die to them. I'm going to follow Aaron J. Until the last 300 meters, I will go in front of me and go in front of him. And I know, I always know when come to the last 150 meters. As long as I jump the first thing in the water jump, I know no one is going to beat me there. So my plan worked very well, and I got what I deserved this year. It was my aim, goal actually, to be a world champion. I've been trying, I tried in 2013, I was silver, 2015 silver. But this year I was aiming to be a world champion, and I got into what I got. Thank you.
Excuse me, you speak big English, me and Charlie speak English. Okay, and I've arranged them.
He is very happy now. Congrats all
winners.
Congrats all athletes for this good time. She doing good time, yeah. He look in advance to prepare himself to the next Olympic championship and world champion. Thank you very much.
Question there, please.
May I ask my question in French?
Oui, si vous voulez.
Sofiane, est-ce que vous aviez beaucoup de pression parce que l'athlétisme marocain était très fort à une époque et un petit peu baissé, donc les jeunes athlètes comme vous, on attend peut-être beaucoup d'eux.
Would you mind repeating your question in English?
I was just asking to Sofiane, he has a lot of pressure on his shoulder because Moroccan athletic was very strong and it was less strong the last year.
Oui, tu sais, au Maroc, maintenant, il y a une nouvelle génération des athlètes. Et Sofiane est parmi les nouveaux athlètes et qui bossent et qui font un grand effort pour arriver à cette médaille aujourd'hui. Donc, grâce à un effort. Mais c'est une révolution pour lui. Donc, c'est une révolution d'athlétisme au Maroc. J'espère que ce sera d'autres qui vont venir, Inch'Allah. Ok, merci.
Would you mind translating that out into English?
Yeah. Okay. You know, in Morocco now, it's a new generation in athleticism. Now it's Sofiane, like Sofiane. Now it's a symbol of for all athletes in Morocco to progress in future and. To take flom in
Inshallah. Thank you. Are there other questions? Yes?
Evan, take us through the last lap. Kind of what you were sensing, and then when Mr. McKeesey, you know, made his move over the last hurdle, kind of watched you. I think you sensed it, you kind of looked back a little bit. So what are you telling yourself in a lap like that?
Yeah, starting the last lap, I still felt pretty good about my chances because nobody had passed me yet. Last year, Conceslas took the lead with a lap to go, so last year I got the sense that he was still feeling pretty good, and he obviously made a huge move on the backstretch last year to show that he felt really good. So when I got passed with 2:50 to go. They, these two guys, they didn't really pull that far ahead of me, so I still had a little hope, and I was still trying to dig and try to have a good water jump and try to fight back that last home stretch. They just pulled away from me, coming out of the water pit, and over the last 100 meters, they were just stronger than I was, and I just wanted to make sure I got over that last barrier cleanly, and once I did, I started kicking it in, and just to be safe, looked up at the Jumbotron, and I had to look a couple times because I wasn't sure what I was seeing, but at the end I did see McKissie behind me, and I got a little worried, and I was like, oh, you gotta really push it in, and I think I took a look back, and saw he was right there, so I just made sure I dug in and got to the finish line before he did, and I'm actually not sure how close it was, but I was happy at that point to just finish and get on the podium.
Are there any other questions? One last one then.
Conceslius, congratulations. When you crossed the finish line, you had this look like, did I win? Is that what was going on through your head?
Yeah, actually, I thought we're thinking that we are going to lose this, we were going to lose this championship. Actually, I watched Evan Shiga in Monaco, and I saw him in his good shape. And the way I was traveling with my injury, I saw him really sure. I thought he was going to beat me in championship. Bagali was here. I know Bagali was really, he was going to be in a podium. I knew that before. And then, last night, I see what am I going to beat those guys. But it's only, it comes to them when they say, why don't I give myself morale and make my mind be strong to say I'm going to be champion, to give my role. I know I always be the first in the last 300 meters, and I get my plans well. So that's why I was finishing the line and thinking, did I win? Because I was not sure. I was going to be there or not. I was really not sure. But suddenly I put my mind to be very hard. And then the race was, it was very hard. But especially the last three laps, it was hard. I wanted to be, I was about to left the race, but only because of the steeplechase. It's a tradition to overcome. And it was my duty, like last year, I think I gave myself a first class, I'm adding the pattern to you. So I see myself as like my duty to win this championship. So I keep fighting. Until after the last lap, I know I was only waiting the first team, the last 300 meters, and then I go in front of everyone, and I did it that way. And now I always see, After I pass somebody in the 300 meters, I always watch the screen to see how it come or who is following me, and that gives me a lot of morale. After riding 100 meters, I had a lot of crowd was cheering. That's why I called them to shout. That's why I put my hand to them, my eyes, say, let me have more crowd. Yeah.
Okay, thank you very much.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thanks so much.